day they tell us deaths soon may be doubling. The next day they say the coronavirus task force may be shut down at about the same time. More mixed madness. Then you have the president acknowledging that reopening our country will likely kill more of us, but we got to get our country back. How can he accept that when he hasn't even come close to doing what he can to avoid more pain and death? Our big guest, the governor of New York. He's trying to hold back the tide the president is surfing. He says there's a safer and better way. He says he even has a plan. Question is, will he be able to execute it? And you remember the ousted vaccine chief who said he was retaliated against for going against Trump on this virus? Well, he just filed a whistleblower complaint. We have his attorney to make and defend his case. Now look, no matter what happens, our standard must remain the same. Facts and fierce accountability for the same. Together as ever as one. Let's get after it. All right, so let the record be clear. The president knows that reopening will cost lives.
Do you believe that's the reality we're facing, that lives will be lost to reopen the country?
It's possible there will be some, because you won't be locked into an apartment or a house or whatever it is. But at the same time, we're going to practice social distancing.
Just to be clear, it isn't a question. No one thinks that you can relax the only standards that are keeping cases down and not have cases and therefore mortality go up. That's a rhetorical question. Now, there's only one answer. Yes, it will happen. The question is how much? And it's hard to believe that the president wants safety to be first when he's winding down his coronavirus response team, according to a senior White House official. So on that score, here comes the spin.
We'll have something in a different form, but the task force for what we've done, I think everybody out there, when they're being very honest, I think the job we've done on testing will shortly be, and maybe even supersede, Doug, the job that we've done on ventilators. We're working closely with the governors. They have everything they need.
Either the task force exists or it doesn't. And in terms of testing, be very clear. No state in this country is anywhere close to where it needs to be to do the job the president has tasked them with doing. Let's get better perspective. Governor Cuomo of New York strongly argues there is a better way than what the president is suggesting. Always good to see you, big brother.
Good to see you. Good to see you out of the basement. Nice haircut.
You like it? The missus did it.
Well, it's clear that she did it. She obviously harbors a deep resentment, but good to see her out of the basement anyway.
Well, if you need any help with the locks, let me know. I'd be glad to do it for you, free of charge. Let's talk about why my wife might be upset at me, the fact that we're all jammed in the house together. A couple of weeks ago, you were here and you said, look, death is death. Nothing else equates with that. Economic realities we can deal with. It was very popular when you said it, went viral all over the place online. 2 weeks later, it seems that that argument is losing. That economic need and a desire and a fatigue with being home is starting to win. Over half the states are doing some kind of reopening. Is it time for you to shift your thinking?
Oh, truth is truth. Facts are facts. They don't change week to week, Chris. I understand the political pressure. I understand the political theory that says let's reopen, let's get the economy going, and that's what it will take to help political candidates succeed. But this virus doesn't play politics. This virus doesn't respect political parties, doesn't respond to political theory. And we know what happens. We've seen countries that have opened prematurely, opened early, felt the same pressure. We've seen what's happened in Germany, South Korea, and China, and the numbers go up. All the reports say that. The FEMA, the federal agency, says the number of cases per day will go from 25,000 to 200,000. The IHME, the projection model that the White House relies on, went from 60,000 deaths to 134,000 deaths projected by early August because of the accelerated reopening. So that's a fact. You know, the virus will transmit, the virus will infect, and the virus will kill.
That's the idea that it is the price of freedom, that is the price of getting our country back, that it is the price of letting families get their money right and get their jobs back and have their dreams not be destroyed. How do you rationalize the price?
Yeah, well, I understand the pressure, and that's the pressure the other countries felt, and they reopened in a dramatic way. The death toll went up, the infection rate went up, and they did a 180, and the people in those countries said, close the valve. We're losing too many people. And I don't believe it's a question of open or reopen. That's how some would like to frame it. If it's open versus reopen, everybody votes reopen. But that's not the choice. It's how do you reopen? Do you just open the gates or do you do it intelligently? And what we're doing in this state, we're talking about reopening, but reopening intelligently, reopening based on facts and data. You know the hospitalization rate. You know the death rate. You know the infection rate. You know the R rate. And monitor those numerical indices. Watch what's going on and calibrate your action to the facts and the data. That's the smart way to reopen. So that's what we're proceeding with in New York. Nobody's saying in New York that we don't plan to reopen. We plan to reopen. Reopen based on facts and data and science, not on political theory or whim, and not dismissing all the data and all the science.
What do you make of the word from the White House official that they're thinking about shutting down the task force? The president, when asked about it, said, well, they'll have something, they'll have everything they need in some different form. What's your take?
Yeah, they want it over, right? This entire situation has been an inconvenience and a disruption. They want it over, and they want to proclaim it over. They've been looking to proclaim it over from day one, right? They went to great lengths initially to minimize it. It then became undeniable. They dealt with it and then left it to the states, but they want it over. That is clear. But the virus doesn't care. The virus doesn't listen. This is not a marketing situation. You can't talk your way around this. That virus is there. That virus is going to infect people. People will die. Those numbers will go up, and that is going to be undeniable. And governors are now making decisions. I get the political pressure. I get the political heat, right? We feel it in New York. But I think overwhelmingly, people understand the reality. They see the death numbers, and death is the one thing, Chris, you can't explain that away, right? People die. And those numbers are going to be undeniable. So all we're saying is let's do it intelligently. Phase it with numerical indicators. Let's watch it. Let's see how it goes. We don't have to make the mistake the other countries made where you go from closed to open. There's an intelligent calibration that can be done by watching the data and then calibrating your actions. And that's what we're going to do here.
But